हेलो फ्रेंड्स फ्रेंड्स टुडे यू आर गोइंग टू लर्न सेकंड पार्ट ऑफ टाइप स्टडी ऑफ स्टेरियस दैट इज यू विल स्टडी हियर सर्कुलेटरी सिस्टम नर्वस सिस्टम रिप्रोडक्टिव सिस्टम एक्सक्रीटरी सिस्टम दीज सिस्टम्स आर इंक्लूडेड इन दिस लेक्चर. So, friends, first of all, you will learn circulatory system. As you know that Asterias belongs to Asteroidea class and phylum Echinodermata. And here, a true blood vascular system is absent. But this system is represented by a hemal system, which is enclosed within a perihemal system. So, hemal system, actually, it is highly reduced. It's made up of intercommunicating sinuses or channels having coelomic fluid containing coelomocytes. And sinuses are devoid of an epithelial lining and they show similarity with hemocoel of arthropods and mollusk, because in arthropods and mollusk, hemocoel is present. Now, it is divided in following parts. Number one is oral hemal ring. So, this is a circular hemal sinus present around the mouth just below the ring canal of water vascular system. So, this is oral hemal ring. You can see in the diagram, this one is oral hemal ring. And second is radial hemal sinuses or strands. This is a radial hemal sinus or strands. They arise radially from the oral hemal ring and one extending in each arm. So these are five in number along the floor of the umbilical groove below the radial canal of water vascular system. They give rise short branches to the tube feet, that is locomotory organ. Third is axial gland. It is also known as heart gland or also known as Brown gland. There are many names for this gland. And this is the main part of the hemal system. It remains enclosed within the axial sinus or perihemal system. And it is made up of connective tissue having many small intercommunicating spaces when filled with a fluid with amoeboid coelomocytes having brown or this axial gland. So this gland is connected with the oral and aboral hemal sinuses at its oral and aboral ends respectively. This is the position of the axial gland. Here you can see this is the axial sinus and this is axial gland or heart gland. And from its aboral end arises a small terminal head process which runs along the stone canal and remain enclosed within a small coelomic sac, that is dorsal sac, present below the madreporite. Here you can see this is the dorsal sac and this is gastric tuft. So paired gastric tufts arise from the hemal sinuses in the wall of the cardiac stomach and open into axial gland near its aboral end. Digested food from the stomach passes into the hemal circulation through the gastric tuft. Next part of hemal system is aboral hemal ring. This is aboral hemal ring and it is a pentagonal ring canal found below the aboral surface of the central disc. The five pairs of zenital hemal strands, these are five pairs. So these strands arise from this canal and extend into gonads. Now, what is the function of hemal system? Hemal system works as a pathway for the distribution of food substances carried by the coelomocytes. Flow of fluid within it, it is maintained by the contractile activity of the dorsal sac. And the axial gland also acts as genital stolon. It produces sex cells which reach to the gonads through the aboral hemal ring and its branches. So actually in Asterias, or you can see in all echinodermates, most of the echinodermate, actually Gonads do not produce any type of sex cells, but it is produced by the axial gland. Now, next is perihemal system. It is derived from the coelom and it is made up of a system of tubular sinuses or vessels which enclose the sinuses of the hemal system except gastric hemal tuft. Sinuses are lined by ciliated cuboidal epithelium. So, it is divided in certain parts such as number one, oral perihemal or hyponeural ring sinus, and the sinus encloses the oral hemal ring sinus. Now, second is radial perihemal sinuses or canals. Each canal encloses a radial hemal strand running into an arc, which forms a vertical longitudinal partition which divides the former into two lateral longitudinal sinuses. Third is axial sinus. This is axial sinus. So, it encloses the axial gland of hemal system and a stone canal of water vascular system. The three axial sinuses form the axial complex. Axial sinus forms a small dorsal sac to enclose the dorsal process of the axial gland. Dorsal sac found below the madreporite. And next fourth part is avoral perihemal ring sinus, and this encloses the avoral hemal ring sinus. Fifth is genital perihemal sinuses, and it encloses the gonads and the genital hemal strands. Sixth is marginal sinuses. These are 10 in number. Total number is 10. Two in each arm, one on each side below the marginal nerve cord, opening into radial perihemal sinuses of their respective arms. Seventh is peribranchial sinuses. Circular. These are the circular sinuses present around the basal parts of the papulae. Now, this is all about the circulatory system. Next is respiratory system. And respiratory system, actually, it is mainly formed by respiration take place by many dermal branchiae, also known as papulae, also known as gills, and 2 feet. So, papulae are the chief respiratory organ in Asterias. And these are the simple, contractile, transparent, hollow outgrowth of the body wall. These are found on the avoral surface. Here you can see these are the papulae in the diagram, just in the bottom. So these are derived from the coelom, and their lumen remain in direct communication with the coelom. So a gaseous exchange, that is between oxygen and carbon dioxide, occurs between seawater and body fluid of the gill. So other other organs, that is thin walled, rich vascularized and moist body parts, also act as respiratory organs. But papulae or dermal branchiae, these organs act as chief respiratory organ. Now, next is excretory system, and here there is no specialized excretory organ. And excretory products are mainly ammonia compound, urea and creatine that diffuse from the body tissue into the coelomic fluid. And from coelomic fluid, they are engulfed by amoeboid coelomocytes, which finally pass out of the body through the papulae. Some excretion occurs through the tube feet by the diffusion. Next is nervous system. It is very simple and primitive type. It is made up of a nerve net, that is of nerve fiber, and a few ganglionic cells, all confined to body wall except visceral nerve plexus found present in the gut wall. Now, sense organ, the primary sense organ is eye. These are simple, pigmented, present at the base of terminal tentacles at the end of each arm. So, there are 5 eyes. And it consists of many photoreceptors, eye pits or oculi. Each eye pit is a cup-shaped pocket of ectoderm filled with a gelatinous tissue. It remains covered by cuticle, below which there is a transparent thickening or lens. The wall of lens is made up of pigment cells containing red pigment granules and visual or retinal cells. The number of oculi in one eye ranges from 80 to 200 in different species. The ocelli are light perceiving organs which detect changes in light intensity. Now, second sense organ is terminal tentacle, and these they have sensory cells which are tactile in nature, that is sensitive to touch, and there are neurosensory cells which are found in the body. These are also sensory in nature. These are present on entire body surface. So these are the sense organs of Asterias. Now, reproductive system. Actually, these are unisexual animal, but there is no sexual dimorphism and no copulatory organs occur in these animals. There are 5 pairs of gonads, 1 pair present in the base of each of the arm, and testes and ovaries. Morphologically, these are similar structure. They have similar position in the body. Testes grayish in color and ovaries pinkish to orange in color. Actually, important thing about the reproductive system of Asterias is that gonads do not produce sex cells, but they originate in aboral end of axial gland, that is genital stolon, from where they migrate to gonads. This is all about the reproductive system, and you can see that the Asterias is taught in various universities and colleges of India as a type study of phylum Echinodermata. So this is all about type study Asterias. In the next lecture, I would talk about the Pentaceros. So like, share and subscribe my channel and press the bell icon to get all my videos. Thank you very much.